Hey, this is Deepak here, and in this video I want to give you a quick overview of CrazyEgg.com. CrazyEgg.com is the tool I use to track heat maps and scroll maps on my website. So I have just logged in into CrazyEgg.com, and here you can see that my account is a basic account, free trial account, and in the basic plan I can have 9 snapshots. And let us just dismiss this notification, and my trial expires in another 5 days. So here you can see that I have 9 different pages. Each page is called a snapshot, and in each page I am tracking what is happening on my site. So let us take the example of the home page. So here in the home page I have tracked for 28 days, and I have tracked 1388 visitors. Let us have a look. I just click on view results, and the home page of my site is loading. This is called a snapshot. So there are different features in CrazyEgg. The most basic feature is the heat map. So heat map is just a visualization of where the visitors are clicking. This does not track mouse movements. CrazyEgg does not have a feature where we can track mouse movements, but it will track the mouse clicks. And mouse click is more or less correlated with the mouse movement and as well as the eye movement. So we will just dismiss this, and here you can see the homepage of my site, and I can see that a lot of people are clicking on the about link. There are a lot of people are clicking on the top articles, my books. Consultancy glossary seems to be not very popular compared to other links. Hire me and contact me is being clicked. To look at the number of clicks that each link has received, I will show you the overlay, but this is the heat map, and here I can see that bit of attention is going to about the author section, bit of attention is going here to the subscription box. I can see that people are clicking on the most read posts, but not much of attention is given to recent posts. Categories, LinkedIn link, archives are also being clicked. And here I can see that people are scrolling all the way down to the bottom, and the more I go down on my site, the number of engagement, the amount of engagement is a bit less. I can see that people are clicking on previous entries as well. Now after heat map, I will move directly to the overlay before we move on to the scroll map and confetti. So here in the overlay, I will be able to see what is the number of clicks that each link is getting. So here I can see about is getting 4.3% of the clicks, 47 clicks. Hire me link is getting 1.9% clicks. Contact me 2.1%. I can see what percentage of people are clicking on the ad. Around 1% are clicking on the ad. That is a CTR, 1% CTR, which is not bad for an ad. So here I can see, you know, how many people are clicking on each of the links. So let's say my LinkedIn link, 0.3%, not much. So it's not very popular. Let us move on to the scroll map. So in the scroll map, you will be able to see the scroll pattern. If you look at the white areas, these areas get more impression compared to the other areas. And if you keep scrolling down, you will be able to see that the website becomes darker and darker, which means less percentage of people are actually going all the way down to the bottom. If I just zoom out, I will be able to see that the top area is the most viewed section, obviously. And then there is a red area, and then there is a green area, and then there is the blue area, right? So this is a scroll map. We have something called confetti, which means so it will show you based on one particular property, and you can select one property. Let's say I select day of the week, and if I select day of the week, and if I want to see people coming on Saturdays, where do they click on? So these are all the clicks received on a Saturday. Let's check Monday. So these are all the clicks received on Monday. So here in my website's case, the clicks are evenly distributed. There is not really any difference compared to the day people visit and where they click. It's all equal. So I can also check window width. So let's say, what is the window width of 1000 to 1100 pixels? People using this screen resolution, where do they click on? And I can check 1300 to 1400 pixels, where do they click on? So different areas like that. So probably mobile users use, 400 to 500 pixels, and I can see where they are clicking on. So here the sampling size is a bit less, but it's enough. So here I am back in the dashboard of CrazyEgg. Here you can see that I have used 39%. So I can track only 10,000 visitors using the basic account per month, and towards the end of the month this will get reset. So let us look at the options available. So there are some options including blocking page camera, API, and checking the installation. If I want to check the installation, if the tracking code is loading in a particular website, I can check the website URL here. There are some API functionality available in Casemetrics. They have also an API documentation for advanced users. There's something called page camera. This is for areas where CrazyEgg cannot access it directly. So areas where only logged in users can access. And you can block certain IPs, like for example, if you are visiting your site and you don't want to track your own clicks, you can block your IP address here. Let us look at the pricing plans of CrazyEgg. You can see that the Pro plus Standard and Basic account. So Pro account has 250,000 visitors per month, and you can load 100 snapshots, and you can see mobile heat maps are available, email support, hourly reporting, and multiple users are available in the Pro account. And you can compare the different plans here. All the plans come with a 30-day free trial. So if you are going for a 30-day free trial and you don't plan to use CrazyEgg further, you might as well go for the Pro account, right? And if you want to add a new snapshot, all you need to click is add. And here you can add your site's URL. So let me try to add a new site page. So here if I want to track this particular page, all I need to do is just select this, go back here, enter the URL and click next. And here I can add a description if I want, not really necessary. There are some advanced options as well, which I am just omitting right now. And if I click next, so here you have some options, start immediately and when to end the snapshot. I'm just clicking on next, and here they have this tracking code. This tracking code I have to include on my page if I want to start tracking it, right? So that's it. And they are saying that we couldn't immediately determine if the tracking should be installed on your page. So I'm just going back to the check installation page. I have the tracking code already installed on my blog. So let me just select this URL, put it back here, and it is testing now, and it will give me a result whether the tracking code has been detected. It says it has not been detected. Maybe I should go and check the URL again to see if the tracking code has been installed. So that's it for CrazyEgg review. I have also published an article on my site about CrazyEgg. And I also have included an article about how you can use data from heat maps to improve user experience. So thanks a lot for watching this video. Make sure you check out my blog digitaldeepak.com. There is the link in the description of this video as well. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.